All right, guys, so this is part two of the first video. So if you haven't already seen the first part, then go back and watch that one first and then come back here and watch this one. All right, enjoy the video. It was really upsetting because I would have loved to be a lawyer. Hold on now, guys. A lawyer for the Innocence Project. I think that would be freaking awesome to watch all of those innocent people walk out of jail. Because there's too many innocent people who are locked up because of the failed justice system. The justice system failed them. And I wanted to be a part of that. I love changing lives, you know? That is my biggest thing. And trying to get people to understand me and people like me, because I feel like we're so misunderstood. And that is a big part. Is a lot of people just misunderstand us, misunderstand what we need out of these people to help us be successful. Because I would hope that each person that watches this, if they are admissions, to maybe consider it, you know? Consider fixing things for the special ed. Because what they're doing is not enough. And I'll be frank with you, it's not very helpful. Because, I mean, it might be helpful depending on what special needs you have. But for me, with people with epilepsy or people with something that has memory issues, it's not helpful. That's just the bottom line. Is there needs to be something in these tests that allow us to have a spark of memory, a spark. And if I were to look at this in several years and actually see progress, see acknowledgement, see loosen up regulation for colleges and for us to be able to get into colleges. Yes, even though I'm speaking on behalf of the special needs, I do think that people who do work their butts off that maybe weren't born with all the intelligence, but they trained themselves to be, I feel like they need a better opportunity too, because I feel like maybe the regulations on how you get to be put on the wait list may need to be overlooked. I don't know, because I won't be a part of that group. I'm only a part of the one that, you know, there's literally no hope for. I just wish that in school I would have been more excited, like all of the other people were, to go to college. I didn't have that. When I went to college, with so much resentment. So much resentment about the regulations of admissions. I was resentful about the out-of-state tuition, because that literally minimizes your choices And again, depending on what state you live in, you barely have any. Like, I was in Texas, barely have any. I know in California, barely have any. Good luck in California. And I just, when it comes down to it, I just think it's depressing. And I really, really hope that someday that one right person will see this and be like, man, we need to come up with better rules because this is just not working. I'm gonna watch over this to make sure that there's things that I can put together, you know, get my message across, because there was a lot of pauses and everything. And oh, I don't know if I mentioned it, and I, like, again, I filmed this twice before, but the one thing I really, really, really liked about the scholarship thing, and I think that there needs to be more of it, are the New York Times scholarship that Harvard offers. And from what I comprehend, it's the people who have been through it all, you know, and come up on the other side. And I think that something like that should be in place for not only Harvard, but other, for other colleges out there, because that was acknowledgement that people struggle. There's other people who struggle, and maybe they don't have the necessary means to go to college, or they were judged on what you write on a piece of paper. That's another thing, is that the education, and that's why I thought maybe if it was more of a conversation kind of test that is not on paper, you know, so they can be more equipped on like of the situation. I hope I worded that right. I don't think I did, but better equipped is my point. I think maybe the whole conversation, then they'll actually know, and that we won't have to be graded on a piece of paper. Because I think it's utterly ridiculous. I mean, for anyone, but also, like, for us, like, for me, I don't want to just sound like I'm just worried about special needs, because I also do believe that there should be better regulations all around. But for, like, me speaking on what I feel like needs to change with special needs admissions regulations, is they need to acknowledge the memory, and I feel like they need to be better equipped on handling the memory issues than just extra time on a test and essay. Because as long as you have essays and fill in the blanks, it's gonna go nowhere. I'm telling you that right now. It's just not gonna go anywhere, because there's no spark of memory in those tests. We just need one word. And I feel like other tests other than fill in the blank and essays could be available. Conversational test, multiple choice test, I don't know, just something other. I mean, the essay is fine, I guess, but if it's like reading or writing or whatever, but the fill in the blank, no fill in the blank, nope. Anyway, guys, hopefully this video has turned out to be something. If not, you'll never see this. But anyway, that is my second time closing it out, so let's just try a third. See you guys soon. Bye.